Hello, Casey Odd here. I wanted to take a moment to talk to you right before I show you this short film. Now, this one's pretty special because it's one that I made several years ago back when I lived in Kentucky. Now, what's even more special about this is that it doesn't exist in a digital copy anymore. It only exists on a DVD, which is becoming an obsolete technology. But nonetheless, I wanted to share it with you. And as a bonus, stick around after the credits because I've got something special for you. So please enjoy Frank Doyle and the case of the burning cigarette.
That bum on the couch is me, Frank Doyle. I'm a washed up private eye prodigy at 29. I've lived a hard life in a short amount of time. See, my last case, I was following a tobacco heiress, Kitty Pinkerton. She was convinced she was being followed by someone, so she hired me, Frank Doyle, to follow her. I found her one night with the lights out at her house. She had been shot through the head with a cigarette. It looked like a sick joke, but it was a murder nonetheless. It was a case that I lost. Since then, I haven't been able to get it together enough to make it through a day without hitting the gin bottle. So each day I put myself together just so I can tear myself back apart. Now I'm staring down the butt of the cigarette that looks just like the one I found in Kitty Pinkerton's forehead. I'll be damned. It's not as easy as you think to pick up a case that's been dead for months. I really don't even know where to start. So I head out on the streets. In a city this size, everything's for sale, even the people. First stop is at a scumbag's house that I was for sure had something to do with Kitty's death. So I'm heading back over there to reopen old wounds and see what bleeds. He was a heavy smoker, and I could tell before I got to his door that he still lived there. Great. Now he's gonna run. He didn't know anything, but that wasn't clear by the way he was running. So I gave him a thank you punch to the gut for making me run in my nice shoes. I needed to clear my head, so I took a walk through the park. I had a feeling I was being followed since this morning. It's time for a confrontation with Frank Doyle.
Hello?
poised to jump because I know how deadly a cigarette can be when it's shot point blank at your face. Apparently I had my wires crossed, and now I just look like some nut job that took a dive on the asphalt. Just when I thought my day couldn't get any worse, I run across this butthead bumming change for cigarettes. I think he got the message loud and clear. Frank Doyle doesn't switch for anybody. Concert's over. It was cool that night, and I'd had enough. I'd played detective all day long. The windows were open, and I could smell smoke inside of the house. I think the old lady's taking up smoking again. She's got her hands on her hips, because she thinks I've been drinking again. She asked me if I found the man I was looking for today, and I knew something was fishy. She said she had planted the cigarette, and that I needed to start thinking like a private dick again. And I guess it's true. I shook down a scumbag, kicked a butthead's can across the street. Just a matter of time before I start busting balls to break.